This is an introduction to titrations. In titration, we use water solutions to make our analytical work faster, easier, and more accurate than we could if we were doing this with dry materials. Why water solutions? Why do chemists prefer to conduct reactions in water solution? Water is a universal solvent. It dissolves almost everything. Now, a true solution is homogeneous. That means every milliliter of the solution, whether it comes from the top or the bottom or the middle, is going to have the same composition as every other milliliter. The number of millimoles in 1 milliliter, therefore, the millimoles of solute, will be the same wherever it comes from. Water is a non-conductor of electricity. There is no noise that's going to obscure the conductivity titrations, for instance. Water is the product of most acid-base reactions. And, of course, there are many interesting salts that are not soluble in water, and so part of our titration could be seeing how much is taken out of the solution. This enables our precipitation reactions to be quantitative. There are a number of types of titration. The acid-base titration is, of course, the most common. It requires, for finding the equivalence point, a weak acid indicator, because there is no other obvious way to find when the number of moles of acid and base are the same. There are oxidation-reduction titrations. Usually, one or the other reagent is going to have a color change. For example, potassium permanganate, which is a very, very vivid purple. When it is titrated into a solution, the permanganate disappears until the equivalence point, and then you have a very, very slight tinge of purple or pink. The precipitation titration is a third type. Precipitation titrations are difficult because the equivalence point is hard to spot. If you're creating a precipitate, what you're looking for is the point at which no precipitate is being formed, and that may be a difficult thing to see. And finally, a conductometric titration relies on the different sizes of ions reacted and in excess to give a change in the shape of the curve at the equivalence point. Remember, the equivalence point is the number of milliliters of added reagent that gives exactly the same number of millimoles of, say, electrons being given and taken. The acid-base titration. The indicator that is used in an acid-base titration has one color at a pH below the equivalence point, and close to the equivalence point, that color changes. So let's look at a problem. Titrating an unknown molarity of hydrochloric acid, 32.20 milliliters, with 0.0520 molar sodium hydroxide reaches a color change at 25.04 milliliters of base. What is the molarity of the acid? You may turn off this playback and solve the problem and then check your answer. This is a strong acid and a strong base. So what is the equivalence pH when you titrate strong acid with strong base? Of course, it's a 7. Now, we know that at the equivalence point, the molarity of the acid times the volume of the acid is equal to the molarity of the base times the volume of the base. Dividing both sides by volume of acid, we find the molarity of the acid, the product of the molarity and volume of the base divided by the volume of the acid. Here, we plug in the numbers for the molarity of the base and the number of milliliters of base titrated, and for the volume of the acid, and the answer is 0.0404 molar, or moles per liter, or millimoles per milliliter. Notice we have 1, 2, 3 significant digits, because in the molarity of the base, we have 1, 2, 3 significant digits. If the pKa of the indicator is close to the equivalence pH, then the rapid change in pH around the equivalence point will make the indicator change colors just like a stoplight. So as we run up to the equivalence point, we have a very small change in pH. But again, this is a very strong acid and strong base, and so when you get close to the equivalence point, you get a rapid increase in pH that will cause the color change in this area, so that when you add one drop of additional base, you're going to see that color change. Methyl orange is the one chosen here. It changes colors just short of the equivalence pH of 7 when you're titrating a strong acid in a strong base. So methyl orange would be a decent indicator if you titrate base into acid. Would work if you titrated acid into base. You can again talk about that in your discussion group.